guys, welcome back to my channel. Tara ng intro yan. So anyways guys, today, it's September 14. I-explain ko sa inyo kung ano yung possible na mangyari sa market. This is anticipating the market with you guys. So I hope sana may maintindihan kayo and sana may makuha kayong tips dito sa gagawin kong explanation for the rest of this live. So ngayon, let's go to Bitcoin, okay? Let's go to Bitcoin first. So, we can go to 4-hourly time frame first, okay? To analyze the higher time frame analysis on Bitcoin. So, as you can see here, ano ba nakita niyo dito? Take highs, right? The BSLQ. There you go. Taken. Short on the lower time frame. Go to the 1-hour time frame. Are we inside of the fair value gap on a daily time frame? That's a daily time frame fair value gap. There we go. As you can see, do we have a MS below the fair value gap on the hourly time frame? Let's take a look. There we go. MS. Did we break the MS? There we go. Do you see a tradable setup on the MS? There we go. Are we going to short position on the MS? Opening below. Do we have a setup? Yes. Short. So now, zoom out. Is this a fair value gap on the 1-hourly time frame? Yes. Now go to the 2-hourly time frame. Do you see another fair value gap? Yes. Go to the 3-hourly time frame. Is that a big fair value gap? Yes. So now what will you make? There we go. A fair value gap right around here. Oh, is this a long position, Sir Kim? Nope. Okay. If hindi niyo naiintindihan yung fair value gap natin, if hindi pa kayo masyadong hasa sa fair value gap, then definitely iisipin nyo long yan pag ganun, no? Iisipin nyo long position yan, iisipin nyo pasabog yan, whatsoever, pero no. Now, go back to 1-hourly time frame. There we go. Are we creating an MS right above the fair value gap? Yun yung tanong nyo sa sarili nyo. Are we creating an MS? If yes, then you know what to do. Okay? So for me, there we go. Back. That's an MS for me. Okay? On a 1-hourly time frame for Bitcoin. Okay, that's an MS. Do you have a fair value gap right around here? Now move on to the 30-minute time frame. Do you have a fair value gap? There we go. We have a fair value gap right around here. Do we have a buy side liquidity right around here? There we go. So go to the BSLQ. There we go. Pwede natin puntahan yan. Okay, nasa inyo yan. Kayo bahala, kayo mag-isip. I just want to give you some to brainstorm. Okay, kailangan ko kayo bigyan ng bagay na mag-brainstorm kayo on your own. Okay, na hindi kayo may spoon feed. Okay, you need to think. This is your assignment, guys. So now, fair value gap right around here. May MS dito. Okay, kahit hindi ko gawan yan. Tignan nyo, ha. There we go. A fair value gap right around here. There we go. An MS right around here. There we go. See? MS. Right below there. So now, do we have a tradable setup right around there? Yep. So for me, I'm thinking a short position right around here. Pwede ko i-short yan. Okay? Pwede ko i-short yan dyan. Pakunta dyan. Then I'll take profit right around resting below this liquidity. Okay? So, but in a higher time frame, in a higher hindsight, go to the 3-hourly time frame. There we go. As you can see, hindi ito magiging reason ng pagsabog ni Bitcoin to the upside. Pwede yun. Pwede yun. Still, di natin pwede discount. Pero still, kailangan natin basagin itong fair value gap natin on a 1-hourly time frame. Kung saan man natin ako yung fair value gap na ito, that definitely on a 30-minute time frame. Yeah. Kailangan natin basagin yung 30-minute time frame ng fair value gap niya na ito. Okay? In order to say na pwede rin lumipad yung pressure to the upside and target this rest of the rest of the imbalances na nakuha natin sa higher time frame. And there we have a fair value gap right around here na pwede talagang balikan. Okay? So, this is my Bitcoin analysis. So, yan ang analysis natin kay Bitcoin. Kayo bahala. Kayo ngayon na mag-isip. Now, Sir Kim, last question. Pwede pa ba namin ma-short si Bitcoin? Pwede pa ba namin ma-short si Bitcoin on a 4-hourly time frame, like yung massively 4-hourly time frame or 3-hourly time frame? Pwede ba namin siya ma-short? Yan to ganyan. Yep. Okay. Again, gayahin nyo lang to. Makakapag-create kayo ng fair value gap And then makakapag-create kayo ng MS sa baba and sa taas. And in this case, meron tayo dito, no? Ayan, nagre-rest tayo right around dyan sa areas na yan. So, possible may MS dyan. Now, meron din tayong MS dito somewhere around dyan sa area na yan. Believe me, meron yan. So, tignan nyo. There we go. That's a support and resistance area. Okay? So, meron tayong MS right around here. Now, kayo bahala. Hindi ko kayo sasabihin ng entry dyan sa areas na yan. Kailangan nyo mag-brainstorm on your own. Kailangan nyo mag-aral on your own kung paano ko papahiwatig sa inyo na pwede na kayo mag-long position and pwede na kayo mag-short position. Who knows? Okay? So, kayo ang bahala now. We have a target right around here. The liquidity on 18,500 something. Okay? So, now, let's move on to S&P 500. Okay? So, for me, S&P 500, I did short position in S&P 500. I took my partials. So now I'm thinking to short position or long position on tomorrow, okay, London session, 2 p.m. 2 p.m. on Philippine Standard Time. So I'm thinking to short and long position on S&P 500 that time. Pero ngayon, I don't know if may trade ako dito. Masyado pa siyang ugly for me. Ay magko-consolidate pa lang to. So for me, tignan nyo muna yung 30 minutes time frame, 15 minutes time frame, kung ano ba ang mga nabuo niya. Now, let's go to the 5 minutes time frame. Do you have a fair value gap? Take a look. There are a fair value gap right around there. Mm-hmm. There we go. And this is a massive fair value gap that we created on Bitcoin, on S&P 500 on 15 minutes. Mm-hmm. Okay. So now, marami pa tayong pwedeng puntahan kay S&P 500 before natin pwede siyang basagin. Okay. So for me, may maximum take profit for S&P 500. Maybe this low. Tatargetin na natin itong this low na to na 3884.5 or 3882.2. Okay. So yun yung mga possible na puntahan ni S&P 500 for me. Pero, I believe, babasagin natin ito ng mas sobra-sobra. So, how can I say so? So, as you can see naman from the history, there we go. Mas lumulundo pa siya ng sobra-sobra. And there we go. Let's go to the daily time frame of S&P 500. We still have liquidities resting below here. Okay? So, pwede natin targetin yan. Okay? Yung ganyan. Okay? So, anyways, guys, that's on S&P 500. Kaya nyo na yan. Imposibleng hindi nyo kayang i-trade yan. Ang dali-dali. Okay? Hanapan nyo lang lagi ng fair value gap. MS, KCC, alam nyo na yun, Kim Candle Confirmation. And then, this is the Solana. As you can see here, we have an MS right around here. Go to the 30-minute time frame, 15-minute time frame, 5-minute time frame. As you can see, you'll have an entries. Right, you'll have an entry right around there sa area. There we go. Break here. Pwede kayo mag-short right around here. Take profit on the resting liquidity, yung support and resistance. Now, let's move on to the 4-hourly time frame. Let's go back to 4-hourly time frame of Solana. There we go. Take the BSLQ. May target ako dito, pero guess what? Nilagyan ko na question mark yan. Sinend ko yan sa kanila. Sinend ko yan sa inyo. Bakit? Kasi I believe kailangan niyang kunin to if and only if babasagin niya yung MS na to. Get what I mean? See? May BSLQ tayo dito. If and only if, tatargetin natin yan, papasukin natin yan, if and only if, basag yung MS. Did we break the MS above that fair value gap? I believe in that. Do we have an MS right below? Yes. Did we break the MS below? What happened to the price afterwards? Smooth. See? Now, do you have a sell side liquidity on Solana? Right around here. The sell side liquidity. Yep. Right here. We have a sell side liquidity. Equal lows. Yep. Definitely. Now, let's move on to the hourly time frame of Solana. Do you see another fair value gap? There we go. I see a lot of fair value gap in this kind of in this movement. So, napaka-interesting. Okay, napaka-interesting talaga ng magiging movement natin ngayon. And guess what, guys? I cannot wait to see melted paces, a lot of melted paces on the market. Kasi they are thinking long position. Okay, but for me, you cannot fight the algorithm to market. Okay? Hindi nyo kaya labanan yung algorithm ng market. Okay? So, yun lang naman yung lagi ko sinasabi sa inyo. So, again, Fair Value Gap, MS, KCC, kayo bahala. Okay? And then, target. Madali-madali yung target. It's either imbalances right below, supply and demand below, liquidity below, and support and resistance below. So, yun lang yun. Okay? So, that's the target. So, for me, let's say for example, kay Solana, sige, bigyan ko yun ng tip. So, let's say for example, sir, kayo, paano ito umakit din dyan? Di ba? So, pag umakit din dyan, nasa hourly time frame ka, then move to 15 minutes to 5 minutes time frame, tignan mo kung ano nangyayari sa market dun sa areas na yan, sa lower time frame. So, definitely, magkakaroon yan ng MS right around here, sa areas na to. Okay? Magkakaroon yan ng MS right around, oh, shit. Okay, so, MS right around there sa area na yan. Now, Sir Kim, paano ko masushort din? Paano ko malulong? Di ba, papasok yan dyan? Okay, magbabounce yan dyan. If we did open multiple candles below or magkaroon talaga tayo ng KCC or yung Kim candle confirmation natin using price action, then definitely we can probably short position the market out. Target this first liquidity that we see on the left side. Okay? Pero, if and only if, okay, if and only if, na ang presyo natin is gumanya, pumasok ng up. There we go. Back, pumasok ng fair value gap, consolidate, nag-create ng MS. There we go, bumalik na naman. And guess what? Nagre-rest yung presyo dito sa area na to. You know what to do. Okay? You know what to do. That's sentido common, which is that's another MS na pwede mo pagkatiwalaan, na pwede mo i-plotting dyan sa system na yan or dyan sa fair value gap na yan. And then, what happened to the price afterwards? If it did break above that MS, open a KCC, Kim candle confirmation on a price action of the playbook, then you can probably long position and take this bigger fair value gap resting above. So, I hope naintindihan nyo to. So, ganun lang ka-basic. So, huwag nyo sasabihin sa akin na hindi nyo kayang i-trade to or whatsoever. It's either takot ka lang or ayaw mo kasi mag-work para sa'yo. That's why you're not trading it. That's why nag-fail ka palagi dyan. Okay, for me, I did give you the best scenarios and same entries na pwede nyo pasukin sa market na to. So, I don't know kung ano pa yung magpapahirap sa inyo dito. Just like this one, no? Just like this one. So, go to the 4-hourly time frame of Solana. There we go. As you can see, oh my god, what happened to my... Okay, nalipat ko. Okay. So, as you can see here, napakadali and napakasimple lang. There we go. May BSLQ ako dito. Tatargeting ko to if and only if basag ang MS. Pero ano ba nabasag? Yung babae. So, short. Pag nabasag yung taas, targetin mo to. Same exact thing here. Go to that 15 minutes, 30 minutes, who knows kung anong gusto mong time frame gusto mo. Pag nabasag niya itong bob ng MS right around here, pag nag-create niya ng MS right around here, pag nabasag yan, then go to the higher fair value gap. As simple as that. Okay? So, do it, gawin niya yan sa the rest na matitiin niyo ngayon, which is I really recommend for you to trade Bitcoin, S&P 500, and Solana. That's it. Yan lang muna. So, thank you so much for watching and I hope you're having a great day so far. That's it. Bye-bye and I'll see you guys later.